I'm not, before I even start, this is how it's gonna work. 7 o'clock show yesterday. People in suits, cranky, blue hair, angry, were out of control with enthusiasm. Oh, 9:30 show, when we didn't think we could beat the 7 o'clock show, those people were like, 7 o'clock show can suck it. And those people were so, we stayed all night with those people. All day we've been talking about how crazy the 11:30 show is going to be.
Leave a bruise, count the days, keep marking time, we're graduating soon.
White trash!
Small Dick.
Wait, come again?
Nothing.
She helps Veronica pick up her lunch tray.
Oh, thanks. We on for movie night? You're on Jiffy Pop detail. What should I rent? Anything with a happy ending.
Wide load! Honk!
Ram, a beefy linebacker, knocks the same tray once again from Martha's hands.
Ram, sweetie, you bastard, pick that up right now!
What?
Mr. Big Football Star, I remember first grade when they sent you home crying because you messed your pants, and guess what? You're still full of crap. Go pick on someone your own damn size.
But she is my size.
Your diary. Discernible personality, but her mom did pay for implants. And Heather Chandler. The Almighty. She is a mythic bitch. They are solid Teflon. Never bother, never harass. I would give anything to be like that.
I'd like to be their boyfriend.
That would be me. Notice me. So beautiful. I'd like them to be nicer.
That would be beautiful.
I'd like to kidnap a Heather and photograph her naked in an abandoned warehouse and leave her tied up for the rats.
Two. The bell rings. Lunch is over. Lights up on the girls' bathroom. Veronica enters. Heather Chandler and Heather McNamara are watching Heather Duke vomit into a toilet.
Grow up, Heather. Bulimia is so 87. Heather's right. Maybe you should see a doctor, Heather. Yeah, Heather. Maybe I should.
Miss Fleming enters, ex-hippie, eccentric...
And Heather. Perhaps you didn't hear the bell over all the vomiting? You're late for class. Oh, it's detention!
Veronica, seizing the opportunity to get in with the popular girls, forges a hall pass for them, foiling Miss Fleming and attracting Heather Chandler's attention. Miss Fleming exits.
This is an excellent forgery. Who are you? Veronica Sawyer! I crave a boon. What boon? Let me sit at your table at lunch just once. No talking necessary. I promise.
If people think you guys tolerate me, they will leave me alone. Before you answer, I also do report cards, permission slips, and absence notes.
How about prescriptions?
Shut up, Heather. Sorry. For a lumpy pile of skink, you do have good bone structure. And a symmetrical face. If I took a meat cleaver down the center of your skull, I'd have matching half sets. Very important.
Of course, you could stand to lose a few pounds.
And you know, you know, you know, this could be beautiful. Mascara, maybe some lip gloss, and we're on our way. Get this girl some blush, and Heather, I need your brush. Let's make her beautiful.
Let's make her beautiful.
Let's make her beautiful. Okay.
Okay.
The Heather's exit with Veronica. It's another day and another lunch.
Why don't you push me?
Out of my way, Pete.
You're gonna die at 3 p.m. Don't you dare touch me.
Get away, pervert.
She looks smoking hot.
Whoa.
Now there's four of them.
About us in the old days. I miss you. I hope you can come to my homecoming party. Love, Ram. Put an XO after the signature.
What's this for anyway?
I just found out that Ram used to hang with Martha Dump Truck.
Well, yeah, in kindergarten, ancient history.
And he kissed her on the kickball field once.
Shut up, Heather.
Veronica finishes the note. Heather Chandler takes it.
Perfect.
Now we give it to Martha.
Oh my God. Wait, wait, Heather, get that back.
What? It'll give her shower nozzle masturbation material for weeks.
Shut up, Heather.
Don't do this to Martha. She's had a thing for Ram for like 12 years now. This will kill her.
Are we gonna have a problem? You got a bone to pick? You've come so far, why now are you pulling on my dick? I'd normally slap your face off, and everyone here could watch. But I'm feeling nice. Here's some advice. Listen up, biatch.
I like looking hot, buying stuff they cannot. I like drinking hard, maxing dad's credit card. Skipping gym, scaring her, screwing him. I like killer clothes, kicking nerds in the nose. If you lack the balls, you can go play dolls. Let your mommy fix you a snack. Oh, oh. Or you could count smoke, count some rum and coke. It
friend. I can tell in the end.
If she had your shot, she would leave you to rot.
Of course, if you don't care, fine, go braid her hair. Baby Sesame Street is on.
Whoa.
Or forget that creep and get in my jeans.
Let's go tear up someone's lawn.
Freeze your brain. know what the big deal.
Get to be a nobody. Come Monday, you're an ex-somebody. A cautionary tale for losers. I know who I'm eating lunch with on Monday. Do you?
Veronica walks the suburban streets. Alone. Soon to be alone. And slightly unhinged.
The demon queen of high school has decreed. She says Sunday 8 a.m. I will be deleted. They'll hunt me down in study hall, stuffing on me on the wall. 30 hours to live, how shall I spend them? I don't have to stay in bed like cattle. I could change my name and ride up to Seattle, but I don't own a motorbike. Wait.
She sees a motorcycle. She is outside JD's house.
Here's an option that I like. Spend those 30 hours. Cause Heather says I got to go. You're my last meal on death row. Shut your mouth and lose the tag you wanted. Get on all fours, kiss this little girl walking. Tonight I'm yours, get this little girl walking. Come on, you know the drill. I'm hot and pissed on the pill. To the little, I'm a dead girl walking.
And all you know, it's cause you're
cherries, black cherries. They're swirling like a melon. Feels peachy and funny.
They're busting like a ripe honey
dude. So honey, do it.
Get down to it.
They try and pain to you.
Cause you are sick down.
They're turning blue, 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 blue.
Like a frostbite victim. You can't be all so blue. Such a long while.
I give you everything I am. My leather jacket, my ring, my rep. Cause only your sweet kisses
can soothe my aching balls.
Don't twist them,
don't tug them.
Just kiss them
and hug them
like Winnie the Pooh.
Make it look like a suicide pact.
The plan includes a fake suicide.
suicide note.
Ram and I died because we had to hide our gay forbidden love from a misapproving world.
Kurt and Ram will wake up 2 hours later, the laughing stock of the school.
Veronica thinks the bullets in Kennedy's gun are harmless tranquilizers. Kurt and Ram arrive for the seduction at the cemetery. Ram wears a tie.
Hey, Veronica.
So, do we just whip it out or what?
Take it slow, Ram. Strip for me.
What about you?
Oh, I was hoping you'd rip my clothes off me, sport. One, two,
three.
Jenny steps out of hiding and nonchalantly shoots Ram. Veronica fires wildly, winging Kurt.
Oh, holy crap!
Jenny chases Kurt and tries to scale a chain link fence in his underpants.
Off the damn fence! Get off the fence!
I don't understand!
We can start and finish wars. We would kill the dinosaurs. We're the asteroid that's overdue.
Stop being a dick.
The dinosaurs will turn to dust.
They
die because we say they must.
Jenny fires. Kurt dies. Veronica runs up.
What the fuck have you done?
I worship you. I trade my life for yours. We'll make them disappear. We'll plant our garden here. Our love is God. 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 Our love is God.
Gun-toting macho dads. Kurt's dad delivers a eulogy.
I don't really know what I'm supposed to say up here. I'm ashamed, certainly. My family has turned our town into a laughingstock. My son Kurt, I didn't really know who he was supposed to be. And when I think about the sick, disgusting things that Kurt and Ram were doing...
You wait just a minute, Paul! It is ignorant, hateful talk like yours that makes this world a place our boys could not live in. They were not dirty! They were not wrong! They were just two stray verses in the Lord's great song.
Our boys were pansies, Bill.
Yes, my boys are homosexual. That don't scare me none. I want the world to know. I love my dead gay son. I'm thinking, praying, read some magazines, and it's time.
Dead gay son.
I'll save my boys in heaven, and he's tanning by.
Jesus says it's cool. They don't have crime or hatred. There's no bigotry or cursing. Just friendly fellas dressed up like their favorite village person. And we're not dirty. They just had flair. They were just two straight remains in a long blonde hair.
Summer of 83.
That was one hell of a fishing trip.
Is
badly damaged, but your love's too good to lose.
Hold me tighter,
even closer.
I'll stay if I'm what you choose.
Can't we be 17?
If I am what you choose.
If we still got the
She applies some lipstick and puts it away.
There was a boy I met in kindergarten. He was sweet. He said that I was smart. He was good at sports and people liked him. And at nap time once we shared a mat. I didn't sleep, I sat and watched him drink. Watched him breathe for nearly half an hour. Ooh. Then he woke up. Pulled the scab off one time playing kickball. Kissed me quick and pressed it in my hand. I kept that scab.
Tonight.
What? Why?
Our classmates thought they were signing a petition. You gotta come out here.
inside. You chucked me out like I was trash. For that, you should be dead. But then it hit me like a flash. What if high school went away instead? Those assholes are the key. They're keeping you away from me. It made you blind, messed up your mind, but I can set you free. You left me and I fell apart. I punched the wall and cried, bam, bam, bam. Then I found you, changed my heart, and set loose all that truthful shit inside. And so I built a bomb. Tonight our school is Vietnam. Let's guarantee they never see their senior
of Westerberg High will die. Our burned bodies may finally get through to you. Your society turns out slaves and blanks. No thanks. Sign the students of Westerberg High. Goodbye! But once the smoke pour out the doors, bring marshmallows, we'll make s'mores. We can smile and cuddle while the fire roars. I was meant to be yours.
And Heather's can truly get along. Heaven, that is where.
Veronica tries to stop them. JD pulls a gun. They struggle for the gun as the timer on the bomb counts down. And the pep rally continues above.
Here
Someone just got shot. We see red spreading across JD's shirt.
Was it good for you? Tell the truth, it kind of sucked for me.
JD passes out. Veronica, with no idea how to defuse the beeping bomb, lugs it upstairs and out to the parking lot. Suddenly, JD appears behind her. Veronica points her gun.
It's okay.
JD gently takes the bomb out of Veronica's hands.
I am damaged, far too damaged, but you're not beyond repair. Try to help them, try to fix them, I'll just get out of your hair. Please stand back now, a little further. Don't know what this thing will do. Hope you miss me, wish you'd kiss me, then you know I worship you. I'll trade my life for yours, and once I disappear, our love is gone.
JD takes the bomb far away from anything living.
Say hi to God.
The bomb detonates, destroying no one but JD. Veronica goes back into the school, singed but alive. And determined to enact change, she grabs Heather Duke and rips off her trademark red scrunchie.
Hey!
And ties it to her own hair.
Listen up, folks, war is over. Brand new sheriffs come to town. We are done with acting evil. We will lay our weapons down.
We are damaged. We're all frightened. We're all freaks, but that's all right.
We'll endure it. We'll survive it. Martha, are you free tonight?
Martha enters in a motorized wheelchair.
What? My date for the pep rally kind of blew me off, so I thought if you weren't doing anything, maybe we could rent some new releases and pop some Jiffy Pop.
Something with a happy ending?
Fuck yeah.
Veronica notices Heather McNamara standing nearby next to Heather Duke.
You coming or not?
Heather McNamara looks at the very angry face of Heather Duke.
Yeah, I'm coming. Next year's college.
Brand new Heathers. High school never really ends. Let's not sweat it for them.